I decided to make Nocturnes the subject of my first recording. People love Nocturnes, people love beautiful melodies. People love Chopin and Fauré and Grieg, and it's important to play music that people want to hear. The Nocturne as a form, as a piece of music, is about 200 years old, and we credit John Field with inventing it. And really, since then, it's about the same as it was. It starts off with a beautiful melody at the beginning, and it transitions into sometimes a darker or a brighter middle section, full of virtuosity, full of fireworks, but definitely a contrast. There are different types of listeners out there. There are the people who study a classical recording, who follow classical music, and follow the performers. And there are people who don't care about the performers, they just love the soft, relaxing sounds that nocturnes might provide. And we're talking about music that can be played at dinner, or in the car, or to fall asleep by. There are many different ways to enjoy this music. Believe me, I scoured the earth for nocturnes. I think I've played every single nocturne ever written, including one by Stan Chinsky. And this, I believe, is the world premiere recording of this. It's out of print, written in 1907, and so this will be a first. The challenge of recording is making sure that you're as spontaneous during the recording session as you would be during a live concert. Doesn't always happen. And especially with nocturnes, because the melodies are so flexible and there's so many millions of ways to play them, to be on all the time is definitely difficult. You know, on the way to the studio, they dropped my piano, you know, about 6 inches off the ground or so.
You know, they dropped it.
I heard that. Well,
I'm about 6 inches, so right in my house.
With you probably standing right there.
Yeah.
Talking about the drop.
Yeah.
I was concerned about that. I said, did anything sound like it got hurt? And he goes, no, it sounded totally normal. It's just a little out of tune. Where did it get dropped? On this corner?
I see a rounded corner.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. Can I listen to it for a second?
Yes.
String on or something? And I think all the tuning, even though it's pretty stinky out of tune, it probably, there's nothing radical that would say, oh, plate cracked somewhere. Mm-hmm. That's always a concern, is somewhere around a strut, you get a hairline crack if it really hit hard, you know? Mm-hmm. I don't hear anything like that.
So it was at the hall for about a week and out of tune, and we had the hall's piano versus my piano. And once my piano was tuned, we decided to go ahead and use mine.
John, we're using this piano. This is my piano, you know.
Excellent. Good choice.
I've owned it 8 years, I think. 8 years. But I was worried, you know, before it was tuned, I wasn't sure, but after it's tuned, it's amazing.
It sounds really good.
Yeah.
And I'm very happy with it, because it sounds, it has just a warm, milky sound. I called my dad. And I said, my next recording is going to be 12 nocturnes. And he says, 12 nocturnes and a waltz. And I said, Dad, you're a genius. And the waltz on this recording is called Waltz for the Lonely. It's written by Chet Atkins, who is no longer with us, but he was an amazing guitarist. And this was a very simple waltz that was written in a hotel room when he was in England for a concert. And I have played this as an encore for years in a very simple way, and I decided for this recording that I would make it into sort of a 1920s grand romantic transcription, and sort of like Godofsky or something, without going all the way into jazz. So it teeters on that, but it doesn't quite go there. But it's very difficult, it's deceptively difficult.
Robert Henry is not without Facebook. Let's see. I'm inspired by the guy who, before he kissed his bride, updated his Facebook status right before that in the wedding. There we go. It's official now.
I should do her first, where I actually update my Facebook status in the middle of a piece, and it's on record. It'd be a first.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because you know, there's some grand pauses in there. You know?
Believe it or not, in the middle of the recording itself, I also updated the Facebook status. So on the final chord of the foray E-flat nocturne, I update my Facebook status. It'll be the world's first.
Sweet.
That actually would be really funny.
That would be.